But I am not very much fond of reception. I want to know how people give reception to this movement. That is my concern.
How long will you be in England?
England, I think I am coming for the second time. Last time in 1967, when I was going to India, I stayed here for 2 days only and then went ahead. Practically, this is the first time I've come.
And for how long now?
That I do not know. I have got so many fathers and mothers to take care. So, as long as they keep me, I can keep.
Hey,
any gentlemen have questions, you can ask them.
Yes, can I ask if this is a very special welcome for you, or is this a performance that you go to each day?
Wherever I go, I've got my disciples. In the Western countries, I've got about 20 centers, especially in America, Canada. So, the American boys are very enthusiastic. I think I got in Los Angeles and San Francisco very great reception. And in Ratha Japra festival, about 10,000 boys and girls followed me for 7 miles.
What do you try and teach, sir?
I am trying to teach what you have forgotten.
Which is what?
That is God. Some of you are saying there is no God. Some of you are saying God is dead, and some of you are saying God is impersonal or void. These are all nonsense. I want to teach all this nonsense that there is God. That is my mission. Any nonsense come to me, I shall prove that there is God. That is my Krishna consciousness. It is a challenge to the atheistic people. There is God. As we are sitting here face to face, you can see God face to face. If you are sincere and if you are serious, that is possible. Unfortunately, we are trying to forget God, therefore we are embracing so many miseries of life. So I am simply preaching that you have Krishna consciousness and be happy. Don't be swayed away by this nonsense, waves of maya and illusion. That is my
Is this singing essential to the sustenance of your faith?
This singing is a process for clearing the dust accumulated on the heart. Our relationship with God is eternal. It cannot be broken. But due to the contact of maya, we are trying to forget Him. But if we chant this holy name of God, Hare Krishna, then maya will not act and we shall very quickly understand what is our relationship with God. That is the problem. Chetadarpana Marjanam, the Sanskrit word is cleansing the dirty heart. The dirty heart. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Namang Duskitanam Murha Prapadante Naradhama. Those who are miscreants, rascals, and lowest of the mankind, and taken all knowledge, an atheistic class of men, they do not know what is God. Others, those who are virtuous, those who are inquisitive, those who are wise, they will try and they will understand what is God. So, my appeal to you is that you try to understand this movement, Krishna consciousness movement. It is not a bogus movement. It is scientific, authorized. Any scientist, any philosopher, any logician may come and you shall prove that there is God and we have got eternal relationship with God. So if you want to happy, then you must take to this Krishna consciousness movement. Otherwise the human race is doomed. Rava bhaktasya kuto mahadguna. Anyone who has no God consciousness, he has no qualification. However, academically he may be very rich. He has no qualification. Manorathena asato dhavatu bhai. His only qualification is mental concoction. Mental concoction. That's all. He has no other qualification. So we reject all this nonsense. We simply accept a sincere soul who wants to dedicate his life for God's service. So it is not easy thing. These boys and girls who are following me, they are very elevated. They are not ordinary boys and girls. They are taken to Krishna consciousness. Their quality is greater than any mundane, erudite scholar. It is a challenge. Jashasi bhakti bhagavata kinchana sarvai gunai tatra samasati sura. Anyone who has developed Krishna consciousness, love of God, all good qualities will automatically develop in him. All good qualities. Test any of our students, how they are good, how they are advanced. Test it. Bring anyone in this world and test any one of our boys. You will find how much difference there is in their character, in their feeling, in their consciousness. So this is the only thing. If you want peaceful society, then you must make them God conscious, Krishna consciousness. Everything will be automatically solved. Otherwise, your so-called United Nations will not help.
Mr. Billy Graham makes people God-conscious in a different way. Can you tell me what you think of him?
I do not know what is Billy Graham, but I am following the Vedic principle, Bhagavad Gita, as it is. Krishna says, sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam bhaja. God says that you give up all nonsense occupation, simply surrender unto me and I take charge of you and give you protection. This is our philosophy.
Can I ask you some questions about your general attitudes on things going on around us? For instance, what do you feel about man going to the moon?
This is simply a waste of time. I already commented on this when I was in San Francisco. The reporters asked me this very question. I flatly replied that it is simply a waste of time and waste of money, that's all.
What about something very much nearer to ourselves here in this country, and that is a war or civil disturbance is going on in a
war is going on between
Christians.
No, we are not Christian, not Hindu, not Muslim. We are God's servant, that's all. Anyone who is God's servant, there is no disagreement. And one is Maya's servant, servant of Maya illusion, there is disagreement. So it doesn't matter. Our taste is savai pungsa maro paro dharma jato bhakti radho khaje. That system of religion is first class, which teaches how to love God. That's all. It doesn't matter whether it is Christian religion, Mohammedan religion or Hindu religion. We shall see if the follower of the religion has learned how to love God, then his religion is perfect, otherwise it is useless.
Do you not think it's worth going to such places as Ireland and trying to talk to the people out there to stop warring?
No, this is our talking, that the first class religion is that which teaches how to love God. Try to understand this. This is the simple formula.
The this, but don't you think it's worth going over there to try and help them?
We shall see. Suppose you are Christian. If you have developed your sense of love, loving God, then you are perfect. Your religion is perfect. But instead of loving God, if you have developed your sense of loving dog, then you have wasted your time. That is your test. You want to ask him question?
No, I think the lady wants to take you away somewhere.
I think that the room is up.
All right.
Trying to say.
I'd just like to know how old you are. How old you are?
I'm 74 years old. I was born in 1896.
Whereabouts?
In India, Calcutta.
Are you married, sir?
Yes, I've got my sons, grandsons, my wife who are living, but I have no connection with them. I am a sannyasi, renounced order. I have got elderly sons.
Yeah. You say you have no connection with your family?
No.
Why?
Because I have taken sannyas, I dedicated my life for Krishna.
I see.
That is the Vedic system. Certain portion of your life you should simply dedicate for God. That is called sannyas.
To do this, did you have to divorce?
No, there is no question now. We do not know what is divorce. In our country there is no divorce, at least in Hindu law. Yes. Wife and husband once combined, that is for life. There is no question of separation. In all circumstances. Either in distress or in happiness. There is no question of separation. Now our modern politicians, they have introduced this divorce law. Otherwise, according to Hindu Manu Sangita, there is no divorce law.
When did you renounce your family?
In 1959.
How are they managing without you?
They are managing. My sons are grown up, they are earning. My wife is also this man's daughter, she has got some property, so they have no problem.
Do you ever see them at all?
No, I cannot see. I cannot see at least my wife. But if my sons and daughters come to see me, they can see. But my wife cannot see me. That is top.
Which wife?
That is the system of sannyas. A sannyasi cannot meet his wife again. That is renouncement. Renouncement means renouncing connection with woman or renouncing sex life. That is renouncement.
Come here this way, sir.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Very good.